Hi everyone, welcome to another episode. This week, something about the i3. So, anyone that owns an i3, and I'll show a video of this, but the navigation system has a built-in a charger location. So you can, not as good as say a Tesla or something like that, but you can go to the menu in the navigation or the map in the car, bring up some the chargers in the area, and can generally find them. Now, previously, when I've seen this, it didn't have, it had some detail, but it wasn't that great. Things seem to have changed recently. So, driving the other day, I noticed that something had changed in the i3 navigation. Now, I don't know how this has been updated or whether I've just not noticed it before since it went to the service in the BMW garage many months ago, but I'm pretty sure this wasn't the case. And please, if anyone knows that the i3 is capable of updates and how that's done, I'd really be interested in it, because I generally don't know. But when I used to use the navigation system to find chargers, which I kind of do on and off, I generally use that map or PlugShare, but in the off chance I use the actual navigation system in the car, this only seemed to have very limited information in the menus. And when you actually went into it, it then did give you, you know, it was an AC or DC, where it was. Now recently, what I've noticed is that whilst that bit still remains, when you're actually searching, or when you go up and find the local chargers, it now comes up whether it's an AC or DC, and the what I assume is from the actual model of the charger. So in this case, ChargeMaster, PodPoint, Ecotrocity, and all those sort of stuff. It doesn't show Polar, it seems to show ChargeMaster, which I think from that could either be BP ChargeMaster, which they've now changed to, or I know some of the original machines had that, so I'm not quite sure, but it didn't have that in that first menu up till recently. Now, I'm not sure how this has been updated, because certainly I'm not aware of an over-air update for the i3. I'm pretty sure that can't do it, but it must have done it somehow. And I've noticed additional chargers come on. So the Ecotricity ones, whilst they showed, it didn't really show much information. It has now. It also shows AC and DC. And then you go into it and you find the individual, what the actual charger is, you know, what speed and whether it's located outside and restricted access, all that sort of stuff. So, anyway, if you guys have the same thing, or you've recently used it and you... like me, it seems to have changed from what it was before to what it is now, I'll be really interested to know your feedback and your comments, because it's something I hadn't noticed before. But certainly I'm pretty sure that first screen didn't have that level of detail. It was only when you got into the second and actually selected the charger. Now the BMW i3 does have, like, whether they're online and offline, and generally that's for the majority, but there's still some that aren't. But I've noticed things like InstaVolt going on there and things like that, which was never on there when I first bought the car. So again, might have been me, maybe I just didn't realize, or something has changed perhaps. Let me know in the comments below. Let's have a little discussion about it. And if you did like this episode, don't forget to like, share and subscribe. And until next time, thanks very much. Bye-bye.